This is a short video on a symmetrical scale, the chromatic scale, the most common one, the one that you probably already know. The difference between a symmetrical and an asymmetrical scale is the pattern of whole and half steps. So, for example, the whole steps and half steps in a major scale are asymmetrical because the pattern goes whole, whole, half, whole, 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 half. So for the major scale, you'd get... Okay, very familiar sound. For a symmetrical scale, the pattern of whole and half steps is symmetrical. That is, it's even all the way throughout the scale. So the simplest example of this is the chromatic scale. And the chromatic scale is simply every single note up by half steps. Now, in the Western musical system, of course, we go by half steps. Some musical systems use quarter steps. In fact, Don Ellis, a trumpet player from the 70s, he had a trumpet that's a quarter tone trumpet, so it could move in quarter tones. So between a C and a C sharp, there would be another note in the middle of those two pitches. Anyway, so I'll play you the chromatic scale for just an octave, and then I'll show you some different patterns that you can use to make this a little more interesting, to make it useful. The cool thing about this scale in particular is that it can go with any other chord progression. Now, you don't want to overuse it because it does sound a little odd or off or kind of out, but it can be used to good effect in just about any improvising situation. So I'm just going to do the chromatic scale from C to C, and I'll go slowly so you can see the fingerings, and then I will show you some patterns that I like to practice that make it a little more fun. So here's the chromatic scale from C to C. Okay, pretty simple. If you're not familiar with this scale, practice it very, very slowly at first so that you really burn that pattern into your brain. Don't go so fast that you're making any mistakes at all. So just go really slowly until you get it down. Once you've got it down, there's all different kinds of patterns you can do with this. Between changing where you tongue. So for example, I'm going to slur one, tongue one on the way up and down this time. Okay, pretty simple. You can switch that around. Tongue one, then slur one. Sounds a little different. Okay, so far I've been doing just eighth notes. You can also do this in triplets, and it falls pretty easily under the finger in triplets, too. Okay. There's a whole bunch of other different kind of patterns. You can do, for example, something like this. Basically, I'm doing triplets again. I'm going up one, down one, and then back up. So basically, this is a very simple scale, very useful scale, and there's all different kinds of patterns that you can do with it. So definitely want to practice the chromatic scale. Have fun. Good luck with your practice.